our kids' service. We're so excited to see you and have so much to share with you. But before we do that, we need you to stand up, make some room, because we're gonna jump into some worship.
Let's get excited as we sing Good to Me. Let's clap our hands.
No matter what I see, no matter how I feel, I have a friend that's true. I know a love that's real. And even when I run, yeah, you're running up to me. And when I mess it up, you're redeeming everything. Even when I fail, even when I fall, oh, I just can't believe that even through it all, you're good to me.
Clap our hands.
This will always be, no matter how I feel. I have a friend that's true. I know a love that's real. And even when I run, yeah, you're running after me. And when I mess it up, you're redeeming.
Custom creations. Discovering individuality. Because God made only one of you. And He did it for a reason. When you discover who you're meant to be, you'll make a difference in the world around you. Custom creations. There's only one you.
Hello, kids. I'm so glad you're here as we start a new series called Custom Creations. This series is all about individuality. Individuality is discovering who you're meant to be so that you can make a difference. God made only one of you, and He did it for a reason. Each week, we're going to discover who you're meant to be and how you can make a difference in the world around you. Our big answer is going to get us started, though. And if you don't know what that big answer is, the big answer is the answer to the big question. This is the one you should get from the important adult in your life. And that is, say it with me, what did you learn in kids' church today? Our big answer for today is, you were made in God's image. And our memory verse this week comes from the book of Psalms. And it says, how you made me is amazing and wonderful. I praise you for that. What you have done is wonderful. I know that very well. That's Psalms 139, verse 14. For our story today, we're starting in the very beginning when there was nothing except God. In the beginning, God took nothing and made everything. That makes sense. From darkness, God created light. God poured out waters and stretched out the sky overhead. God shaped dry land, canyons, and mountains, then filled them with trees and plants of every kind. God created the sun, the moon, and the stars. Then God filled the oceans with fish and the sky with birds. God thought up an amazing variety of animals to crawl and hop and race over the earth. Everything from tiny ants to thundering elephants. All of this was incredible. I mean, unbelievable. And yet, it was all just a warm-up for God's most awesome creation. So let's read about that in the book of Genesis. Genesis chapter 1, verse 27 reads, God created human beings in his own likeness. He created them to be like himself. He created them as male and female. That's right. God created people, Adam and Eve. God created them in his image. God made human beings to be like him. Of course, Adam and Eve were just the beginning. God has been creating people ever since. Everyone, all over the world, no matter where they live, what they look like, or what language they speak, all people were made by God in his image. And that includes you. Yes, each and every one of you. God loves us. More specifically, he loves each one of us more than we can even possibly imagine. Every person you'll ever meet, boys and girls, men and women, people of every age, race, and culture, we are all of infinite value because we are made in the image of God. Of course, that doesn't mean we all look exactly like God. What it does mean is that each of us can show what God is like in our own special way. The more time you spend with God is when you can ask God to transform your thoughts and words and choices, the more you become uniquely you. As you follow Jesus, you'll discover the amazing and wonderful ways that God has made you who you are. You'll discover the purpose he has for your life. You'll be able to show his kindness, faithfulness, goodness, and love to others. And you can live out your individuality with confidence because you can trust God no matter what. So the next time you look in the mirror, remember, you're looking at the image of God. And there's no one else in this world who can show what God is exactly like the way you do. We know that's true because we can see how God created people in the first place. When God created the world, he saved the best for last, people. And God made people in his image. That means God made all people with different qualities that could only come from him. You and I can show what God is like through our individuality. We can share God's love through our unique skills, talents, and abilities. We can show how kind, creative, peaceful, forgiving, and joyful God is with the way we live every single day. Doing this helps us walk out what our big answer says. You were made in God's image. God loved all of us individually so much that he chose to send Jesus to take care of all of our sins. And all we have to do is accept that gift and invite him into your heart. Sin is what keeps us separated. Until we say we're sorry for our sins and ask Jesus into our hearts, we aren't a part of God's family. So I want everyone to bow their heads and close their eyes. And if you're here today and you'd like to make Jesus your best friend and start following him, would you just say this prayer with me? Just repeat after me and say, "Dear God, I believe you sent your son, Jesus, to die on the cross for me. I'm a sinner and I'm sorry. Jesus, I give you my life. Be my Lord and my very best friend. In your name I pray. Amen. We love you so much, and we can't wait to see you next week.
It's time for Memory Verse Breakdown!
Hey kids, today we're gonna break down this week's memory verse. Are you ready? Okay, here's this week's memory verse. You think you got it? Try saying it out loud. All right, let's take some words away. You think you still got it? Try saying it out loud again. All right, let's bring those words back and see how you did. Did you get it right? Awesome. Well, that's this week's memory verse breakdown. How'd you do?
Memory verse breakdown!
Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, it's time for another round of Just in Slime! The incredibly popular soon-to-be daytime TV show where you, the audience, answer Bible trivia questions to avoid getting slimed. Don't worry though, this is a television show, so we haven't yet figured out how to get the slime through the TV to you. But we're working on it. The rules are simple. I'll read a statement, then you'll have 5 seconds to decide if that statement is true or false. If you think it's true, then stand up. If you think it's false, then sit down. True, stand. False, sit. Easy enough, right? If you choose the wrong answer, you get slimed! Think you can make it through all 6 questions without getting slimed? Well, we're about to find out, because it's time to play Just in Slime! Here is the first statement. Jacob was Esau's father. True or false? Remember, stand if you think it's true, but sit if you think it's false. Okay, time's up. Who's standing? You just got slimed! Jacob was Esau's brother, not his dad. Now it's time for round two. Esau traded his birthright to Jacob for a bowl of soup. True or false? Don't forget, stand for true, sit for false. Okay, time's up. Who's standing? You are correct. I see you are starting to get the hang of this. Let's see how you do in round three. Jacob promised to work for 7 years for the chance to marry his wife, Rachel. True or false? It's time to decide. Okay, time's up. Is anybody sitting down? 'Cause you just got slimed. Jacob did promise to work for 7 years to marry his bride. Oh, how romantic. Okay, moving on to round four. Esau was never able to forgive Jacob for taking his birthright, and they fought their whole lives. True or false? Okay, time's up. Who is sitting down? You are correct. Although they had their disagreements, Jacob and Esau did not end up fighting their entire lives. Ooh, only 2 rounds to go. Jacob's name was eventually changed to Israel. True or false? Time is up! Who is sitting down? You just got slalalalimed! Jacob actually did become known by the name Israel. Ooh, here comes the final round. Jacob became the father of Abraham. True or false? Time is up! Is anyone standing? If so, you just got slimed! Abraham was actually Jacob's grandfather. Oh, well done, everyone! If you avoided the slime through all six rounds, that is very impressive. Thanks for playing Just in Slime!
Thank you so much for being with us today. Before you go, have that important adult in your life go to lifechurchgreenbay.com/kids, where you can grab our Kids Connect card. There you can discuss our big answer, memory verse, and even more. We love you so much. Have a great week.